Hi, today we will see about steady state error sample problems, which we have already covered the theory last video. So first problem we will go through: a closed loop system whose open loop transfer function is given here. Find the steady state error when the input is r of t is equal to 1 plus 2t plus 1.5 t square. So they have given the g of s into h of s. They have given the question. Also, they have given a steady state value as r of t. So you have to find out what is kp, ka as well as kv. So for r of t is equal to 1, kp is equal to limit s tends to 0, g of s. We studied as g of s, but in the question here they have given as g of s into h of s. So take the thing together. So this equation you have already studied. Now what you have to do in the sense, you have to apply it. Limit s tends to 0. Equation you have to write 10 divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2. So you know that 1 by 0 is infinite, so the total term will become infinite. Therefore steady state error, we know that ess is equal to 1 by 1 plus kp. It is infinite, so 1 by infinite is 0, so you will get ess as 0. Now we have to find r of t is equal to 2t, where we can find kv, velocity constant. So kv is equal to limit s tends to 0 s into g of s. So you have to substitute s into the equation what they have given over there. So ss will get cancelled. Remaining is d 10 divided by s plus 1 into s plus 2. Apply limit 0 s tends to 0 there, so that it will become 10 divided by 0 plus 1 into 0 plus 2, that is 1 into 2. So that equation will become 10 by 2, which is equal to 5. Therefore ess is equal to 1 by kv, which is equal to 2 into 1 by 5, which is equal to 0.4. Now we have to substitute r of t is equal to 1.5 into t square. You know that k is nothing but limit s tends to 0 s square into g of s. So you substitute the g of s over here, so that you will get limit s tends to 0 into s square into 10 divided by s into s plus 1 into s plus 2. So numerator denominator s terms are there, so only one s term will get cancelled. Numerator one s term will remain, so that s will become 0. So anything into 0 will become 0 only, so that you will get k is equal to 0. Hence ess is equal to 1 divided by k, which is equal to infinite. Therefore we can write the total steady state error as 0 plus 0.4 plus infinite, which will be equal to infinite. So your total steady state error for the given system is infinite. Second problem is the block diagram of a unity feedback system is given, and in that inner output derivative feedback is also shown here. You have to calculate the steady state error for unit ramp input. Also you should choose the value of k such that the unit step response of the system has no overshoot and yet it is as fast as possible. System, you can see here, system they have given 100 by s square, and the feedback they have given one as ks and another one as unity feedback. So you have to find, first you have to find only for the inner block, that is with respect to 100 by s square as well as ks. Later you can consider, once you find out the transfer function of that, which you will call it as g dash of s, and after that you can put it as a system and you can find what is g of s. So first we will find what is g dash of s. It is nothing but 100 by s square divided by 1 plus 100 by s square into ks. It is nothing but g of s divided by 1 plus g of s into h of s. So once you simplify, you will get it as 100 divided by s into s plus 100k. Now what you have to do in the sense, you have to find for 1 by kv using a unit ramp equation. So kv is equal to limit s tends to 0 s into g dash of s. So s into g dash of s is nothing but s into 100 divided by s into s plus 100k. You have to apply limit s tends to 0. So ss will get cancelled. Remaining is 100 divided by 100k, which is equal to 1 by k. So ess is equal to 1 divided by kv. So it will become k. Now for a closed loop transfer function, c of s by r of s is equal to g dash of s divided by 1 plus g dash of s, which is equal to 100 divided by s square plus 100ks plus 100. So for no overshoot, zeta will be equal to greater than or equal to 1. When we combine it with the standard equation of second order, you can get omega n is equal to root of 100, which is equal to 10, and 2 zeta omega n is equal to 100k. if for the fast response theta will be equal to 1, therefore 2 into 1 into 10 will become equal to 100k. From that we can easily find what is k value. K is equal to 0.2, therefore ESS is equal to k is equal to 0.2 you will get. Now we'll move on to the third problem. For a unity feedback control system, the open loop transfer function g of s is equal to 10 into s plus 2 divided by s square into s plus 1. Find position, velocity and acceleration constants. Also, they have given the steady state error when the input r of s is equal to 3 by s minus 2 by s square plus 1 by 3 s cube. So, first we have to find the constants, and we are considering here as unity feedback system, hence h of s is equal to 1. First, we will start with position error constant kp. Kp is equal to limit s tends to 0 g of s into h of s. So, g of s into h of s is 1. So, we have to substitute only the g of s value. So, limit s tends to 0 10 into s plus 2 divided by s square into s plus 1. So, as s tends to 0, the whole term will become 0. Therefore, it will become denominator term, whole term will become 0. Therefore, kp will be equal to infinite. Now, we'll move on to kv. Here it is limit s tends to 0, s into g of s. Therefore, limit s tends to 0, s into 10 s plus 2 divided by s square into s plus 1. So, s will get cancelled. Remaining is only s term will come in the denominator. So, s tends to 0 means the whole term will become infinite. Now k is equal to limit s tends to 0 s square into g of s. So what will happen in this one? Equation will become s square into 10 into s plus 2 divided by s square into s plus 1. So s square term will get cancelled. Remaining is limit s tends to 0 10 into s plus 2 divided by s plus 1. So once you apply s to 0, it will become 10 into 2 divided by 1, which will give you 20. Now you have to find the steady state error. Steady state error for non-standard input is obtained using generalized error series, which is given below. E of t is equal to r of t into c naught plus r dot of t into c1 plus r double dot of t into c2 by 2 factor plus etc. And also they have given r of s is equal to 3 by s minus 2 by s square plus 1 by 3 s cube. You have to take inverse Laplace transform of r of s so that you will get what is r of t. It will become L inverse of 3 by s minus 2 by s square plus 1 by 3 s cube. So once you take inverse Laplace transform, you will get it as 3 minus 2 t plus t square by 6, which will give you the r of t. Now you have to find out r dash of t as well as r double dash of t as well as r triple dash of t. So once you find r dot of t, it is nothing but d by dt of r of t. Once you go for differentiating that, you will get minus 2 plus t by 3. Now we have to go for finding out r double dot of t. It is nothing but d square by dt square of r of t. So you will get it as d by dt of r dot of t. Once you take the r dot of t as minus 2 plus t by 3 and put it over here, you will get the answer as 1 by 3. Similarly, you have to find out what is r triple dot of t. It is nothing but dq by dt cube of r of t. So you have to take it as d by dt of r double dot of t. R double dot of t is 1 by 3, which is a constant, so that you will get 0 as the answer for r triple dot of t. Now you have to substitute all those things and find what is c naught, c1 and c2. The derivatives of r of t is 0 after second derivative. Hence, we have to evaluate only three constants, c0, c1 and c2. The generalized error constants are given by c0 is equal to, this is standard equation, c0 is equal to limit s tends to 0 f of s, c1 is equal to limit s tends to 0 d by ds of f of s, c2 is equal to limit s tends to 0 d square by ds square of f of s, where f of s is nothing but 1 divided by 1 plus g of s into h of s. Here h of s is 1, so f of s is nothing but 1 divided by 1 plus g of s. So once you substitute it, you will get it as s cube plus s square divided by s cube plus s square plus 10s plus 20. Now this is your f of s. You have to find c naught. C naught is equal to limit s tends to 0 f of s, which is equal to limit s tends to 0 s cube plus s square plus divided by s cube plus s square plus 10s plus 20. So all the terms, if you are substituting it to 0 for s, you will get the answer as 0. Now we have to find what is c1. C1 is nothing but limit s tends to 0 d by ds of f of s. So you have to differentiate with respect to s. So once you differentiate f of s, you will get the equation as 20s cube plus 70s square plus 40s divided by s cube plus s square plus 10s plus 20 the whole square. Now we have to apply s tends to 0. Once you apply s tends to 0, you will get the answer of C1 is equal to 0. Now we have to find what is C2. How you will find C2? In the sense, you have to find limit s tends to 0 d square by d square into f of s. So once you apply like that, you have to find you already got d by ds of f of s, so you have to take it as limit s tends to 0 d by ds of f of s. So you know already d by ds of f of s, substitute over here, simplify it, differentiate it, so that you will get the answer as 1/10. So c0 c1 c2, you got it now. So you have to substitute it in the error equation. So e of t is equal to r of t into c0 plus r dot of t into c1 plus r double dot of t into c2 by 2 factorial. So substitute what is r of t and what is c0, so that you will get 3 minus 2t plus t square divided by 6 into 0 plus r dot of t is minus 2 plus t by 3 into c1 is 0 plus r double dot of t is 1/3 and c2 is 1/10 into 1/2 factorial. 2 factorial you have to substitute, so that you will get answer as 1/60. Therefore, steady state is nothing but ESS is equal to limit t tends to infinite e of t. That is limit t tends to infinite 1/60. We don't have any t term over there. It's 1/60 is a constant. So your steady state error will become 1/60. So all these problems I have solved now. Sample problems I have solved now. Next topic will be PI, PID and PD introduction. Till then, thank you.